JagranJosh.com brings for the aspirants current affairs video of the week 5th September to 11th September 2015 that will be of immense help in their preparation. Current affairs headlines. Ruling People's Action Party won Singapore general elections. India to purchase 10 Heron TP drones from Israel. UNGA adopted resolution on raising of flags by non-member observer states. Management of minority educational institution cannot exploit its employees, Allahabad High Court. 10th World Hindi Conference held in Bhopal. Jhumpa Lahiri awarded with 2014 National Humanities Medal by White House. INS Vajrakosh commissioned by Defence Ministry at Karwar. Union Cabinet approved India's preferential treatment to LDCs in trade services in the WTO. First ever census on India's leopard presented. Union Cabinet approved National Offshore Wind Energy Policy 2015. Jharkhand Government approved the formation of Anti-Terrorism Squad in state. CCI imposed penalty on Kerala Film Exhibitors Federation. Experts discovered existence of thriving port town in Thanjavur district in Sangam era. Shane Watson retired from Test cricket. Indian-Australian Navy Bilateral Maritime Exercise Ocean Dex 15 started. Current affairs in detail. Ruling People's Action Party won Singapore general election. The ruling party with 83 seats won the elections for a record 12th time. The Opposition Workers' Party ended up with just 6 seats. PAP is headed by the incumbent Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong. It was the first election held after death of Lee Kuan Yew, father of modern Singapore. India to purchase 10 Heron TP drones from Israel. Heron TP is a missile-armed drone. It has been developed by Israel Aerospace Industries. It is capable of flying for 52 hours of continuous flight. Heron drones can carry a payload of over 1,000 kg. These drones will be operated by the Indian Air Force. UNGA adopted resolution on raising of flags by non-member observer states. It was adopted by record vote of 119, including India, in favor. The resolution was introduced by Iraq by the President of the Arab Group. Flags of non-member observer states shall be raised at UN headquarters. With this, Palestine and Vatican would be flying the flags at UN headquarters. Management of minority educational institution cannot exploit its employees, Allahabad High Court. Management cannot harass employees on basis of the Article 31 of Indian Constitution. The petition regarding this was filed by a Kanpur-based college principal. The principal was expelled by a minority-run education institute without any proper explanation. As per the court, the management also violated the UP Intermediate Education Act 1921. 10th World Hindi Conference held in Bhopal. It was organized by the Ministry of External Affairs. The objective was to propagate the use of the language across the world. They deliberated on 16 aspects for universalization of Hindi language. India has hosted the event for 3 times, including the present conference. Jhumpa Lahiri awarded with 2014 National Humanities Medal by White House. The medal was conferred onto her by the US President Barack Obama. She is a professor of creative writing at Princeton University. Her debut collection of short stories, Interpreter of Maladies, came out in 1999. She won the 2000 Pulitzer Prize for Fiction, the Penn Hemingway Award for the same. INS Vajrakosh commissioned by Defence Ministry at Karwar. It will be the biggest missiles, ammunition and spares dump on the western seaboard. It is the third naval establishment commissioned at Karwar in Karnataka. It was constructed as the second phase of Project Seabird initiated in 1985. Together with INS Kadamba, INS Vajrakosh is now the world's largest naval base east of Suez Canal. Union Cabinet approved India's preferential treatment to LDCs in trade and services in the WTO. It covers market access, technical assistance and capacity building and waiver of visa fees. Implementation of the Article 16 of the GATS will have no direct financial implications. Other two components will cost 5.5 crore rupees to the exchequer. The move is aimed at increasing trading opportunities for LDCs with India. first ever sensors on India's leopard presented. It was presented by lead scientist of the tiger sensors, Yadvendradev V. Jhala. There are around 7,910 leopards across India except the Northeast India. Madhya Pradesh with estimated 1,817 leopards leads the count. Karnataka follows Madhya Pradesh with an estimated 1,129 leopards in the wild. Union Cabinet approved National Offshore Wind Energy Policy 2015. Seeks to harness offshore wind energy potential in India's exclusive economic zone. Objectives of National Offshore Wind Energy Policy 2015 are to promote investment in the energy infrastructure, to reduce carbon emissions, to encourage indigenization of the offshore wind energy technology. Jharkhand government approved the formation of anti-terrorism squad in state. The state cabinet also gave its approval to create 243 ATS posts. It will be headed by an official of the rank of superintendent of police. It will also have 6 DSP and 11 inspectors in it. CCI imposed penalty on Kerala Film Exhibitors Federation. KEEF was penalized for contravening Section 3(1) of the Competition Act 2002. The directive was given on the basis of a petition filed by Messrs. Crown Theatre. It was alleged that KEEF didn't allow screening of Malayalam and Tamil films in its theatres since May 2013. Experts discovered existence of thriving port town in Tanjavur district in Sangam era. It was excavated at Mandripatinam fishing hamlet in Tanjavur district, Tamil Nadu. The remains include copper coins, terracotta figurine of an ox head among others. The port town relates to the Sangam era and the Middle Chola period. Sangam era relates to 3rd century BCE to 3rd century CE. Middle Chola period ranges from 850 to 1250 CE. Shane Watson retired from Test cricket. He will continue his international career in the ODIs and 2020 internationals. His 10-year Test career came to an end at the Ashes opener at Cardiff. Watson is a right-handed batsman and a right-handed fast-medium bowler. He debuted in the Test cricket on 2nd January 2005 against Pakistan at Sydney. Indian-Australian Navy Bilateral Maritime Exercise OSINDEX 15 started. The 9-day exercise will conclude on 19 September 2015. It is conducted under Framework for Security Cooperation unveiled in 2014. It seeks to strengthen defense cooperation between the two countries. For more on current affairs, log on to jagranjosh.com.